According to Fred Bigra, the Kijangi village chairperson, plastic waste has greatly affected aquatic lives, leading to a decline in fish production since fish normally breed at the lake shores. Bigra says as leaders, they have tried to fight against plastics by banning them, but because they are very many, they end up in the water. We normally do a general cleaning once in a week, but it's not enough. If we can get a pit where people can collect and dump these plastic wastes, it would be easy for us to manage.
These bottles, we are the same people who bring them. In case if we buy like a soda or water, you take it, you drink all, then you buy it, you can put it somewhere like that.
Martin Mosoke, a fisherman at Kijangi landing site, says most fishermen at the landing site use plastics to make their nets float on water, as they cannot afford the required floaters. Mosoke has faulted leaders and law enforcers for increased plastic waste disposal at Lake Albert. Jenna Ndahura, aged 54 and a fisherman at this landing site, says fishing is no longer profitable. We used to get more fish during the start of the month, up to when the moon comes out. But nowadays, things are not going on as they used to be. Bigra has asked manufacturers to come up with alternative materials which can decompose. We would like to request government and manufacturers to start making things that decompose. Annette Faida, the woman parish councillor for Tonya Parish, says there is a need for adequate community sensitization.
People are there using those bottles due to there are some trees which those people were cutting, they use now. Those trees, they were destroyed.
According to the United Nations Environment Programme, more than 300 million tons of plastic waste are produced globally every year. Report compiled by Ambrose Nwagaba Katoto for the news.